So, Maurice Linguist has been it has been announced that he's leaving for Buffalo, a Group of Five program who is really a no-name, leaving a blue blood level program like Michigan. So I don't know about you guys, but boy, I am mad. I'm very, very mad. This is exactly what describes me. This man has been recruiting very well for us. He's been working hard from what I can tell. He's been here for 4 months as well. And then all of a sudden, reports come breaking today at noon. This man is one of the two finalists for the Buffalo job. And whoop-de-doo, he takes it. Like, in an hour and 30 minutes ago, it's breaking. Oh, he's taking the job. He's replacing Lance Leipold, who won several national titles at the University of Wisconsin-Whitewater in the Division III level and brought Buffalo to some recent success with a 10-win season in 18, an 8-win season and a bowl win in 19, and a top 25 finish last year in the controversial COVID year. He is now the head coach of the Kansas Jayhawks. So, okay, one, I'm shocked. But at the same time, being a Michigan fan of late has been like walking on nails or constantly hearing nails scraping the chalkboard, base boosted 100 times. So, while I am mad, this isn't going to ruin my day. I'm so numb. I'm numb to this after about an hour or two, which is why I'm recording this now, so that I don't lose my passion, because I do want to talk about this. And the first thoughts that came to my mind are, this is an embarrassment, this is going to affect recruiting, and this is just going to further divide the fan base. And looking back, I thought about this for a while, I think all three things are true. The division of the fan base, I already see people on social media raging about this. Like, they're saying we can't ever get anything good. This program's a dumpster fire. Like, everything's just blowing up. And it's awful. Same with the recruiting. Now, recruiting has been awful. We've had some decommitments, and we've been in the running for several five stars. But after this, it's like, wow. Like, Michigan can't even hold an assistant co-defensive coordinator for 6 months. Let alone, not even a year, and he gets hired away by a Group of Five program. Nah, man, that's unattractive to recruits right there, and everything. And his strategies are already being implemented with the core. He's already obviously coached a lot of the cornerbacks, and being a co-defensive coordinator, he's probably shared some strategy, or at least like I don't know, doing what defensive coordinators do, coach the defense. What more can you say? But, like, him leaving, what's that going to do to the players' morale and the, like I've mentioned before, the fan base morale now that he's gone? It's a dumpster fire. The fan base, they're being a little too toxic about it, but they're not wrong. This is awful. This is atrocious. Having a team that allows 7 touchdowns last year, we do the right thing and fire the defensive coordinator. We hire a defensive coordinator and co-defensive coordinator, which I think is great because it'll have guys that can bounce ideas off each other's heads. And then you tell me we do one thing right with hiring coordinators and another school poaches them away. Not even like Ohio State or Oregon or Alabama or Texas, or let alone Texas Tech, because that's a better name than Buffalo. The Power 5 program versus Group of 5 doesn't matter. Power 5's more attractive. Buffalo ain't Power 5. And all in all honesty, there's three options, in my opinion, as to why he left. Option A, he's young, he wants experience, he wants to rise up to the next challenge. Option B, which kind of ties in, but he just wanted more. He just wanted to be back at a school that he's already been at and maybe make the same or more money without having to coach such big responsibility. Because Michigan is a bigger school, wider range. People pay more attention to what you do with the bigger schools. Let's be honest here. Or which kind of ties in further, all three kind of tie in with each other, but option C, where he left directly because of Michigan. He's like, wow, these cornerbacks are crap. I don't know if I can fix this. So I'm going to leave to Buffalo, which will probably grant me safer security for having a job in college longer and later. And I'm thinking it's option C. Because, I mean, we were terrible last year. We actually bottomed out on defense for the first time in forever. Our defense is normally solid under Harbaugh, and like it has been forever. With the last year's defense was like watching rich highlights of Rich Rodriguez's defense, but an even more inept offense. It was awful. It was absolutely awful. We're back to where we were after Lloyd Carr has retired. And this is what I'm going to continue to drive this forward. We need to go back to that point and go to innovation. Now, Rich Rod was the bad decision in retrospect, but we didn't know that. There were some things about his time at West Virginia, some way he treated his players, and the way he implemented his strategies too quickly to an offense that had not at all used speed. He made some mistakes, but it wasn't bad to go for innovation. And that's what we need to go to now, especially now. Harbaugh is implementing some more spread strategies. I mean, do I think they're true spread strategies? No, of course they're not. It's Jim Harbaugh. He's stubborn. But he's implementing them just enough, and he's recruiting at a higher level. He's recruiting players that would thrive in the spread on offense, too. Solidly believe that, especially on the wide receiver end. And I mean, even like he's recruited and get brought in transfers from spread schools or schools that have a much faster pace. We now are at the opportunity to where we can finally, hopefully, move to something better than the old ways. But back to this, I think a great point to move to those new ways would be hiring a new co-defensive coordinator. Now, according to MLive.com, where I've got most of my news from today surrounding this, Kentucky defensive backs coach Steve Klinkscale is being linked to Michigan, possibly. However, there's also that chance that Harbaugh could reshuffle the deck. I have the same cards as last time, like playing a game of war. I have the same cards. They're going to do nothing, but if I reshuffle them, they won't know what's going to come to them. And that works, but that only works against Mickey Mouse bad teams. Doesn't work against Ohio State or Wisconsin or Penn State when Wisconsin and Penn State are solid. It doesn't work. And I hope that Harbaugh is wise, and despite the fact that I want him fired, I would be proud of him, and I want him to do what's best for the program. So I do want him to hire another co-defensive coordinator, hopefully that Kentucky guy, because I do have faith in anyone that Mark Stoops down there hires to be a part of his staff. So I hope Harbaugh makes that correct decision and hires Steve Klinkscale. However, we don't know if that's going to happen. Nothing's guaranteed. And A, the damage has already, in my opinion, been done. Him being hired away, the whole coach stability thing, that's going to be shaken up. Recruits are going to be questioning our coach's stability. They're already going to be questioning it with Harbaugh's contract regardless. This will make it worse. The fan base is very, very divided as it is. This is only dividing the fan base worse because they're questioning the staff, especially Harbaugh. They're questioning everything. And I would be too. I kind of am. Like now, I'm wondering why he left. Like, did Michigan not try to retain him? And if so, did they realize they made a bad hire? What's not being said here? Because there's definitely more than, like, basically what would be one full page double-spaced report. There has to be more. And I'm excited to see if there is any more news. But the man is the primary recruiter of Will Johnson and Cody Jones, most notably, who are top four recruits out of our seven recruits that are currently committed to us. Both are four stars. One's a five star. Like, they've both fit like that. Above, both good. And we don't need to lose more recruiting like confidence. We just don't. And dividing the fan base, everything is just pointing to a rocky road in the fall, and I don't want that. And even, it's just not looking good. This is painful, and this sucks. And if you're not a Michigan fan, you have the constitutional right to laugh at us, because this is horribly laughable. This wouldn't happen anywhere at a school that is close to Michigan's level in program tradition, besides what, Nebraska? Seriously, like, come on. That's all I have. That's all the thoughts I have. Just want to get that out. Do you think that I'm overreacting, or do you think this is reasonable? I think this is reasonable, more reasonable than my Indiana take. Just remember that if you've reached this far into the video, like, subscribe, share this around. Tell me what you think about in the comments below. What team should I discuss next? I'm always looking for suggestions on content. I'll eventually always find some. College football, thankfully, is one of those things where there's always content, and that's something I love about it. But I want to see what you, the people, want. So tell me in the comments below. Again, like, subscribe, share, turn on the notification bell. Thank you for watching, and I'll catch you later.